all going well. Here we are going into Wednesday's workout. It's also going to be our last day of the burpee challenge. So far, you guys are just killing it. A little confusion in the beginning with how scores were going to be kept track of and posted, but we finally, by this time, we've got everything ironed out. And, you know, definitely a David and a Goliath kind of fight out here. We are definitely David on this point, and Milo is at Goliath. They're definitely a larger size gym than we are. Really sorry, I was actually, every time I would bring out a piece of equipment, I was doing a set of burpees, so I'm a little gassed. So, what do we have for you guys on Wednesday? Okay, so for your warm-up, you guys are gonna do two rounds. We're gonna do 20 jumping jacks, and you guys are going to do 20 high fives, all right? And then you're gonna do 10 and 10 of body weight lunges. So 10 on left, 10 on right, okay. High fives, just as a reminder, if you want to high five a wall, you can. If you just wanna be in the middle of your living room, you can do that as well. But you guys are gonna be in that plank position, holding your center nice and tight, and I want you to reach up as high as you can over your head with full extension of your arm, okay? Just not these little quick little taps, okay? Make sure you get that full extension. If going up above your head is just a little too hard, then you can come straight out. For those of you holding your body weight is just a little too much, then go ahead and elevate up on a chair or back of your couch or, you know, an end table, something like that. And you'll still support your body weight, but you'll be an invert, so not as much of your body weight will be pressing down on you, and you can still do those high fives for you. For those of you that can't do jumping jacks, I want you to do my, Judy loves these, cheerleader kick out. So you're gonna go straight up and then straight back and forth, okay? So you just kind of think about a mannequin, and a mannequin that just is gonna whoop and whoop. All right, the rest of you, make sure you get the timing right with your jumping jacks, hands, feet, you know, feet go out, hands go up at the same time. All right, so two rounds of that. Warm up, I want you guys to do nice deep hold in your quad stretch. I'm standing on a 25-pound plate, I don't know if you guys notice, maybe I'm a little bit taller, just a smidge. About 2 inches. Let's see if any of you guys would notice. So quad stretch, and then rolling right into that knee hook. Okay, again, find them five on the side, or, you know, find a place in your home where you can kind of pace it. From there, we're gonna go single leg deadlift with a high kick across the body. Okay, single leg, work on your base balance, have that nice flat back, okay, and just into the hip for me. From there, I want you guys to do sumo walk, so you're gonna do sumo facing forward, so I'll come off my plate. So you're gonna have a soft bend in your knee, and you're gonna round, and you're gonna step out, round, and step out, okay? So you're trying to open up those hips. After that, I want you guys to go into 20 calf raises. So you're just gonna come up nice and tall, extend the ankles, okay? Hold for a second or two at the top. If you need to hold on to something, go ahead and hold on to something so you don't lose your balance. From there, if you guys will grab your broom or your PVC pipe, you guys are gonna get pass-throughs in for me. Let's get six of these done today. So front to back, all right? And wrap that on your back, okay? And from here, I want you guys to give me 10 good mornings, nice and slow, flat back, push that butt straight back, go down, feel a nice little tug in the hamstring, hold for a second or two, and then come up with some control. From there, you guys are going to do 10 air squats for me, slow and controlled down, and then at the 10th one, I want you to stay at the bottom of the squat, and you guys are going to do some presses from behind the head, 10 of those, and then 10 more on the pass-throughs, okay? So we're gonna imagine right now, we got all my squats done. Here I go, you're gonna go straight down, and then from here, active press up, 10 of those, and then holding, get your pass-throughs in, okay? Go down as far as you guys can. The big thing, keep that chest up, okay? Don't look down. Try and hold that chest up nice and high, but keep the core engaged. You don't wanna sit there and break the back, okay? So that's gonna be your warm-up and stretching, okay? From there, you guys have your workout. So every 3 minutes for 6 reps, you're gonna do 10 dumbbell snatches, okay? If you have a backpack, I want you to actually do more of a clean and then a jerk, okay? Having that snatch with that backpack and the extra room for those weighted objects to float in there, probably not a really good idea. So let's go over the snatch real quick. And so since it's 10 of them, it's gonna be 5 and 5. So you will alternate. So you're gonna have your weight right into your lifter's box, okay? Remember, your lifter box toe to heel, okay? Be selfish with that area. You're going to grab your weight. Other hand can be off to the side for balance, so squat down, receive it. We're gonna pull it up like we're zipping our coat, as high as we can pull it, and then from there, you're gonna pull under, okay? So here we go. So you pull up your zipper, and then pull underneath, okay? When you return, you can pass right here, but you have to pass and go back down to the ground before you can do the next one. Okay, so you're gonna alternate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. done, okay? You're gonna wanna go through this fairly efficiently. So for those of you with the backpack, you're gonna have your backpack, all right? I'm gonna move this, by the way. Backpack, hold onto the handle, or you can roll the weight up, whichever works better for you. But again, you still wanna be in your lifter's box. You're gonna clean, okay? And then from there, you're gonna jerk, okay? The jerk, remember, it's a dip, you start to drive, and then just before you're ready to punch, you're gonna drop under again, okay? So elbows nice and tight in front, hand out to the side for balance. So quick flexion, a drive, and then a dip, okay? So the reason I put the jerk in there is because depending on the heaviness of your backpack, you know, you might need that little extra drive under the bag to get it fully locked out. Just make sure that you guys have got control and you're going straight up and you're not letting that weight of that bag pull you, okay? You just gotta set everything as close to your body as you can. Be safe that way. All right, so once you guys have that done, then you guys are gonna go lunges. They're overhead, all right? You're gonna go 5 and 5. If you have a dumbbell or a kettlebell, you're gonna go single arm. Backpack people, I want you guys to do both arms together, again, because the weight just shifts way too much in this thing, and I don't want our shoulders going out in a wonky position. So it's gonna be up to you on how you hold it. For me personally, I've got a couple, you know, the two little handles there, but you have that little small one. Whichever preference works better for you, you can just hold on to that. Lost my little thing there. Okay, nice tight core, so don't be arching this way. Keep it nice and close, and you're gonna step out to the side. Nice little tap of the knee. Nice little tap of the knee, okay? So you will alternate 5 left, 5 right. For those of you with dumbbells or kettlebells, okay, from here, you can keep it up on your last snatch, okay? So whatever it is, lock it out. And then 5 on this side. And then you go, oops, wrong one. 5 on this side, okay? For those of you with any issues when it comes to lunges, go to your VMOs. Okay, they can be weighted VMOs. You can hold on to your backpack, you can wear it, or you can hold on to your weight in a goblet style, but you'd be standing on an object, okay? From here, your toe is facing up, your heel is gonna tap, okay? And you'll switch. If you want, you can just keep going with all 5 on 1, and then 5 on the other. But last but not least, you guys are going to do 24 double unders, 72 singles, or if you can't jump, you get your toe taps, okay? And these will go pretty quickly, so you're gonna have 72 of these. So you'll have your toe, and you'll just tap. If you just need to go as fast as you can and keep the jump out of it, go ahead. So the way this is gonna work is you have 3 minutes to get all 3 of those movements done and build in some rest, okay? Have fun with this one, guys. I'll wake up in a second. Brain burn. Oh, yeah. All right, sorry. Have fun with this one, guys. Again, if you guys need anything, feel free to reach out to us. I've been hearing little bits and pieces from everybody, and it sounds like everybody is doing really, really well, and that makes us extremely happy. Don't forget, we are grounded from the gym, and we love our Backtone family. You guys have a wonderful Wednesday. Can't believe we'll be sliding right in the middle of the week, but we are. Again, if you guys need anything, reach out.